Welcome back, everybody. You are watching the Now Morning Show right here on TTT, also on Talk City 91.1 FM, and of course, streaming live on Facebook at TTT Live Online. Now it's time for conversations with the TTPS. Joining me this morning is Inspector Sheridan Hill, and we are going to speak about littering and all that it encompasses and the penalties for that as well. Good morning, Inspector.
Good morning, Kari. Thank you for having us.
Thanks for joining us this morning again. You know, it's always great to be informed of, you know, the role of the TTPS when it comes to certain things and to get education on what our offense is and the consequences for such offenses as well. And this morning, speaking about littering. So let's start off. What are the general consequences for littering from a legal standpoint?
Okay. Again, before I start, I just want to say that as this is our customer service week, right. It is the motto of the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service to protect and serve.
Yes. Right.
So we have to serve Trinidad and Tobago. All right, and one of the ways in which we serve Trinidad and Tobago is, as you mentioned, educating, informing our members of the public so they partner with us.
Right.
So they don't break the law, and we keep the country safer, more secure. And as we're talking about littering, also from a health perspective, especially in light of recent changes in the weather patterns and so on.
Right.
So briefly, littering is an offense. And it's an offense that the police has a power to arrest without a warrant. So it's the same.
So you can arrest.
Yes.
It's an offense.
Yes.
You can actually be, you could go to prison for.
Yes, you can. You can. And, you know, earlier on we were discussing is something that, you know, members of the public should know, that even in instances where the law only provides a penalty, there is always an alternative term of imprisonment. So it's something to remind members of the public.
So what you're saying in a nutshell is you could either pay the fine or face prison time that is proportionate to the amount the
fine is. So let's just quickly talk about littering. The Act defines litter as means any solid or liquid material product or combination of solid or liquid materials or products, including but not limited to bottles, tins, logs, sawdust, derelict vehicles, cartons, packages, materials, paper, glass, food, animal remains, garbage, debris, and a lot more.
The list goes on.
Yes, yes. And the law speaks about littering in a public place, even though you can also be charged for littering someone's private premises.
Right.
So public place, according to the Act, includes every motorway, road, street, footpath, accessway, alley, any park, garden, other place, waters to which the public has access, waters, you know, talk about sea and rivers and so on, every wharf, pier, jetty, any forest land within the meaning of the Forest Act, airport within the meaning of Section 2 of the Act, any public burial ground within the meaning of the Burial Grounds Act, and any other place that's in the open air or open to the air on at least one side to which the public has access.
Right.
So, virtually almost
everywhere. And
said, any place.
Also on someone's private property.
Private.
So you
private
can't go
property.
And throw your garbage in your neighbor's yard.
No, you can be prosecuted for that.
Right.
In the same fashion that you can be prosecuted for littering in a public place. So the law speaks about littering without reasonable excuse. And I want to caution members of the public that the Act says in any proceeding against a person for an offense under this section, that's where we talk about littering, the absence or unavailability of a receptacle shall not be a defense. So as Lisa was mentioning earlier on Charlotte Street, where there is no bin,
right,
for how much ever distance, you know, one might think that it might be reasonable to litter. Then that is not a defense because
right,
you're not seeing a dustbin close by.
Yeah, it's still your responsibility.
Yes. And there are also offenses for the drivers of motor vehicles. In the case of public service vehicles, and you're supposed to provide a receptacle in the vehicle. It's also a charge for the drivers or the operators of those vehicles to not provide a receptacle in the vehicle. So if someone throws something out of a vehicle, both a public service vehicle and a private vehicle, it's also an offense that you
right,
can be prosecuted for.
Yeah, because I've seen on many occasions people using the nation's roadways and they throw litter out of their car with impunity.
Exactly. It's an offense.
It's an offense. And, you know, the question now is how ready is the TTPS is to enforce the law and such as pertains to littering?
You know, excellent point. Excellent question, because there is a view out there that that's a minor offense,
yeah,
and we should be running after the heavier stuff, the more sexy stuff, for want of a better expression,
right,
the drug traffickers and so on.
Yeah.
But it is against the law.
It is.
And we have to start and somewhere, but not just that, enforce all the laws of the land. It's not only from a police and law enforcement perspective, but it also benefits the health and safety of everyone.
Okay.
We also want to remind members of the public that it is an offense to obstruct the litter wardens in the execution of their duty. And if you interfere with the receptacle, it's also an offense to do that.
How can we identify litter wardens?
Well, they should be in uniform. We have the uniform right now.
Right.
But they should also have an ID, an authority, a document indicating who they are, and so on. So if they're not in uniform, they're supposed to identify themselves to you.
Okay. Right. And Inspector Sheridan, I just want to jump in here because you said earlier, Lisa, and not to be confused with Lisa Rodriguez, our floor manager, who was talking to you about having the receptacles on Charlotte Street and so on. But just to say that, you know, walk with a bag in your car so that if you don't see a bin where you are off to, you can just put it in your own garbage bag in your car and then dispose of it when you get home or when you get to a bin. You know, so it's all about keeping a clean scene, keeping the country clean.
That's
so
right.
That we, you know, just about being clean. And
yeah,
healthy,
I mean, yeah? To me, like, it seems so straightforward.
So straightforward, yeah. Just about being clean. Yeah.
I couldn't agree with you more. But we just want to remind people that it is an offense.
Mm-hmm.
It is an offense that the police has a power to arrest without a warrant.
All right.
I think a lot of people are not aware of that. And the traffic wardens, and the little traffic wardens, the litter wardens, they have a similar power. And under the Litter Act, there are a number of categories of persons who have the same powers as a litter warden under the Act. So sometimes people feel that they're ignorant of the law, they don't know the law. There's a very important legal principle that says ignorance of the law is no excuse.
All right.
So you can't go to court and say, I was not aware that that is against the law, and I was not aware that a police officer, litter warden and so on, can arrest me for littering.
All right. Well, on that note, Inspector Sheridan, always a pleasure having you on the program. Carrie, we have to take in a few messages.
All right. And we come right back with the rest of the No Morning Show. Stay with us.